In the previous video for creating well-structured Microsoft Word documents with headings, part 1, we learned how to create properly structured documents with headings and about the numerous benefits. I used a formatting that was set up in the syllabus template already for color, font, size, etc. In this part 2 video tutorial, I'll demonstrate how to create custom styles for heading structure in Microsoft Word documents. Custom styles can give you the look you want without changing the structure. I'll also provide some brief guidelines to keep in mind when creating an accessible document. To demonstrate how to create custom styles, I'll use the syllabus Word template that I downloaded from the GRCC website at grcc.edu/syllabus. I've already downloaded, opened, revised, and included additional content in this syllabus template. I'm using Word 2013 to view and edit the syllabus, but most of the features are similar in other more recent versions of Word, other word processing applications, and on the Mac or Windows. I clicked the View tab and checked the box to show the navigation pane. With this pane in view, I can easily see an outline of the document and the structure of the headings. Please note, though, that the navigation pane is only available on PC, not on Mac. The title at the top is a Heading 1 style. General information is Heading 2. Instructor name is Heading 3, and so forth. Remember, maintaining the structure is necessary for easy readability, consistent appearance, being able to use Word's automated features, such as table of contents, and to work well with assistive technologies. A well-structured document holds up well also when exported to other file formats such as HTML, hypertext markup language, and PDF portable document format. There are a few different ways to change the formatting of headings and still maintain the structure. I'll demonstrate two of the methods to revise existing styles for the headings. In the first method, I'll use the Styles task pane, and in the second method, I'll update the style in the Styles group on the Home tab. I'll begin by revising the Heading 1 style that I'm using for the title of my document, CO205-2576 Advanced Windows Operating System. That's my title. I'll revise it by using the Styles task pane. Notice I have my insertion point positioned in the Heading 1 text of the document, that is in the title. In this first method, I'll use the Styles dialog box launcher located on the lower right of the Styles group on the Home tab. After I click the Styles dialog box launcher, the Styles task pane is opened. Since I have my insertion point in the Heading 1 text of my document, the Heading 1 style is selected in the pane. I can see the Heading 1 style is also selected in the Styles group on the Home tab. The Styles group on the Home tab is for more commonly used styles. The Styles task pane on the right of my screen will show more styles and provide more options such as managing your styles. With the Heading 1 style selected in the Styles task pane, I'll click the drop-down menu to the right of the Heading 1 style, and then choose Modify. This opens the Modify Style dialog box. In the Formatting section in the middle of the dialog box is where I can change the formatting to whatever I like. Currently I have Verdana for the font. I'll leave that as is. I'll change the font size a little bit larger from 14 to 22. I'll leave the bold on, and I'll change the color to a blue color here. I can also use the Format button on the lower left of the dialog box for several other options to control formatting. For now, I'll just leave it at Verdana 22 bold and then blue. After you have the look you want, there are a few more options located on the lower left of the dialog box. Add to Quick Style Gallery option Add your new or revised style to the styles group on the home ribbon so that you can easily access it. This is a nice convenient feature and it saves time, so I'll leave this one checked. Only in this document option means that your new or revised style in this case, is only available in this document. In this case, my revised style will only be available in this syllabus. No other documents I revise or create. I will not see my revised style in the styles group on the ribbon for any new or existing documents. New documents based on this template means that your new or revised style will be available in all documents you create. I'll select this option. That way, not only will I have the style available in this syllabus, but when I create additional course materials, I'll have the revised style available in those documents as well. I can use this style to make all my course documents look consistent. Automatically update means that if I ever revise my style in a document, that is, if I later select my style in a document and revise the font, color, or whatever, the style itself will be updated to reflect the change. Sometimes this can have unpredictable results. I would recommend leaving this option unchecked. Now that I have customized my style with the look I want, I'll click OK to close the dialog box. Since I chose the option Add to the Styles Gallery, I can see my customized style in the Styles group on the home ribbon. Notice it shows the blue color that I chose. Also notice the structure in the navigation pane is the same. I changed the formatting of my style. I did not change the structure. You should always use the styles, not the options in the font group alone, to create and preserve document heading structure. Remember that I chose the option New Documents based on this template when I customized the Heading 1 style. Let's see how this works. From the Quick Access toolbar, I'll click the New button to create a new document. Notice the Customize Heading 1 style is available for the new document. Again, the color is blue for Heading 1 style in the Styles group. Any future course materials will have my customized style available. I can create many course documents that all have a consistent appearance using this Heading 1 style. To summarize so far, I revised the Heading 1 style for the title of my document by using the Styles task pane. That revised style is available in the Styles group on the Home tab. That revised style is also available in any future documents I create. For the second method to create customized styles, I'll update the style in the Styles group on the Home tab. To demonstrate how to revise an existing style using the Styles group, I'll use the existing Heading 2 style that is currently used for general information, section policies, college policies, changes to the syllabus, and the new section I added for learning resources. I'll go ahead and close the Styles task pane as I no longer need it. I'll select the general information as that is the first text to have the Heading 2 style. Next, I'll apply whatever formatting I wish from the font group. I'll make it a little larger, 14 in size. I'll leave it at Verdana. And then I'll change the color on this one too. I'll use a little bit lighter color than I did for the Heading 1 style. I'll also add a little more spacing. So after the Heading 2 style, I'll make it so that there's more spacing after the text. Notice in the preview here, I'm adding a lot more spacing after my Heading 2 styles. And then I'll go ahead and click OK. Now you can use whatever formatting you want. I just picked a few that I prefer. To maintain a consistent look, though, I need to revise the Heading 2 style itself. Remember, whenever you use options in the font group to revise a heading, you need to update that heading in the Styles group. The font and the Styles group go hand in hand for formatting. One way to easily update the style with a new formatting is to right-click the Heading 2 style located in the Styles group on the Home ribbon. After I right-click the style, I'll then choose Update Heading 2 to match selection. Now that I have updated the Heading 2 style, scroll down and notice that all the Heading 2 styles have been revised to the new formatting. Also notice in the navigation pane on the left of the screen that the structure of the headings is retained. We changed the formatting, not the document structure. Whenever you manually change formatting for the headings in the font group, it is important to reflect the changes of the styles themselves in the Styles group. This is essential in order to take advantage of the many benefits of proper document structure that Word provides. The advantage to the second method is that it's quick and easy. The disadvantage to this method is that you do not have additional options as we did with the first method. For example, I do not have the ability to make the revised Heading 2 style available in any other course materials I create. I'll need the task pane to do that. Regardless of which method you use to revise or create custom styles, there are a few general points to consider when designing a document that is easy to read for everyone, including those that may have a disability. Sans serif fonts, fonts without strokes, such as Verdana and Arial, are a safe choice. For example, I'll switch back to Word, look at the font drop-down menu in the font group on the Home tab, and I have the Verdana font chosen, and that's a sans serif font without stroke. Here's Arial. Times New Roman is a serif font. I'll scroll up so that you can see it. Times New Roman serif font has strokes, and it's considered not as easy to read for online course materials. Font size can vary depending on the purpose of the text. Generally, headings should have a larger font size than the body. Higher level headings are larger than lower level ones. For body text, 10 to 12 point size generally works well. However, the size can change considerably depending on what type of font you use. You can use color in your documents, but it should not be used to convey information, as some colors cannot be distinguished by people who are colorblind. Also, the color of your text should contrast well with the background color. In summary, I demonstrated two methods to create custom styles. In the first method, I used the Styles Group dialog box launcher to access the Styles task pane. I revised the Heading 1 style used for the title of my document. This allowed me to choose from various options, including making the new style available for future documents. The second method was a quick and easy way to revise the formatting of styles. First, I selected the text and then I changed the formatting. I changed the formatting in the font group. Next, I updated the style by right-clicking it in the Styles group on the Home ribbon. Whenever you use the formatting options in the font group, remember to always update the corresponding styles in the Styles group to retain the structure of the document. Finally, I mentioned a few guidelines to keep in mind when creating accessible documents, including use sans serif fonts such as Verdana and Arial. I recommended font sizes and some color considerations.